What if a change was made? What if the society considered the minds of innovative individuals? What if the word standardized was demolished from the field of education? Just imagine how the society would look like if it revolves around diverse minds of younglings who can come as one and bring in different colors of ideas. The educational society runs on a type of view which I classify as black and white, a very simple, plain, and unsophisticated color. I want to see a significant change on the educational society where it runs on a view with an array of colors, accepting individuality and creativity of each individual. Hi, I'm your most typical 11th grader. I'm from Thailand and currently studying in an international school. Started off as a junior in August of 2017, I found myself buried in talks of the SAT among friends. So what is the SAT? As defined by dictionary.com, the Scholastic Aptitude Test, abbreviated as SAT, is a set of standardized college admissions tests developed by the College Board. The principal one measuring mathematical and verbal reasoning, and others measuring knowledge in specific subject areas. The test covers a matter of two subjects and comes in the form of multiple choice. The essay part, though, is optional. Now, after becoming involved in group chats, you see, I asked myself, what is there to worry about since this test is mainly used for people who seek to go and study abroad in the States? It turns out that many countries now worldwide are implementing standardized tests as an application towards university. This becomes a problem because many teenagers follow popular trends around the internet. It is easy for them to go along with it without familiarizing with the subject well-roundedly. One increasingly popular trend dealing with tuition institute is the teaching of standardized tests. In Thailand, it is very common for students to do extra tutoring outside of school in all sorts of different subjects. I myself picked up a third language outside of school. It is unbelievable how much it actually costs. Tutoring, especially for a standardized test, is excessive, unnecessary, and very costly. I truly believe that education should not be turned into business markets, but with many places open, sadly, education is slowly turning into a monetary value. I believe that the foremost performance of students cannot be measured off based on one single fixed test. Standardized tests are types of tests in which it is formed in a very mannerly way. It requires for students to possess knowledge of the core subjects in school, mainly reading and math, and a set of formed questions will be arranged for students to answer. Standardized tests calls for a standardized score, hence its name. Many individuals around the world fumble and give their all to take it. Some fly across a country just to take it because the test centers in their home country can't supply them with seats. Now, may I ask the importance of taking standardized tests? The purpose mainly serves the point that we are using a standardized and consistent score to compare ourselves with others and for our schools to be able to compare their performance to others. That is basically it. Though it requires minimal time to mark standardized tests because of its computer-based marking system compared to a marked free response test, does it bring out the best potential in students? Standardized tests encourages students to memorize rather than being critical in applying the knowledge. According to Diane Ravitch, a research professor of education at NYU, she suggested that test-taking skills and strategies took precedence over knowledge. Teachers used the tests from previous years to prepare their students, and many of the questions appeared in precisely the same format every year. Exact same questions reappeared. Instead of standardized tests as an application towards university, students should be measured with tests that focus on critical and analytical skills, which will then be implemented with life skills in the future. For example, instead of starting a question with what, focus on why and how. This forces the students to apply what they have learned rather than memorizing it. Now, may I ask, do you want the future generations to become robots or a blooming field of flowers filled with diversity of skills and knowledge? If minds become careless, then change won't take place. For many decades, a lot of significant change has taken place. The first computer, electronic numerical integrator and a computer, was invented in 1946. It was huge and bulky, making it unable to move. Around 40 years later, the first laptop was brought into this world. This was a more compatible and convenient version of the computer. But it is melancholy that education remains untouched. We're still sticking to the same way we've always did. Let's look into baby steps we can take. I strongly stand by my point to start taking away standardized tests. Ravitch once said, "Sometimes the most brilliant and intelligent minds do not shine in standardized tests because they do not have standardized minds." By the continuing use of these tests, education reforms won't emerge, and therefore the discovery of the unknown in a student's mind won't even touch upon others. As I end this speech, it is in your hands to make a change into continuing to identify the educational society with the black and white, or alter flaws in the educational society, which can result in an array of colors. Thank you.